الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعين ونستغفره نعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها فإن كل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة كل ضلالة في النار وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين Praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and He's the only one worthy of praise. I seek His help, His guidance and His forgiveness. I believe in Him and I trust Him. I seek refuge in Almighty Allah from the evil of our passions. Indeed, whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides him to Al-Islam, no one can mislead him after Allah, and whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put him astray, no one can guide him after Allah. I testify, O believers, that there is no deity worthy of worship other than Allah Rabbil Alameen. And I testify that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his messenger and the seal of all the prophets. O Muslims, you must know that the best speech is the speech of Almighty Allah, which is the Quran. The best guidance is the course of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which is his sunnah. The worst of all affairs is innovation, an addition to the religion of Islam. Indeed, every addition to the religion of Islam will lead to hellfire. I adjure you as well as myself to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Fear Allah, that means have the taqwa of Allah, be God conscious, and don't die unless you are in a state of Islam. Inshallah, my intention in this khutbah to give you or to focus on one single verse and one single hadith. As they say, al-kalam yunsi ba'duhu ba'da, that too much talk, it make people forget the other talk. So let's try, you understand, to focus today in one verse, listen, try to understand, and let's try to work on it. If we do this, that means next year, in the same time, we have 360 some verses that we had put them in action, not memorize them. It's good to memorize, but we need to start to think about, if we leave the Jum'ah with one single verse, and that we try to put it in action, or a hadith. And I select for today, inshallah, from Surah Al-Isra, Surah number 17, verse number 53. It's needed for the Muslim community. It's needed for husband and wife. It's needed for father and children. It's needed for everybody, because everybody talks. Everybody talks. Some talks is so cheap, and some talks, you know, but everybody talks. But before I get to this, it's so amazing that Islam talks, about your speech, about your tongue. Islam has nothing. I saw this Islam is something about building a nation, building a Muslim community, and all the... Yes, but guess what? Do you know how beautiful Jannah is? How great Jannah is? I'm sure all of us looking forward, inshallah, that will be there. And we read a lot about how beautiful Jannah is. But can you see that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam saying in hadith, man yadmanu li ma bayna lihyayhi wa bayna fakhidayhi aw rijlayhi admanu lahu al-jannah. Subhanallah, insurance. Insurance from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, not a fake insurance, a real insurance. And given by Allah to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he's telling us, whosoever grantee whatever between his two jaw, that means your tongue, your mouth, and whatever between your legs, your private parts, I will grantee him Jannah. The whole thing, the whole mission that we try to go to Jannah. But look, the insurance in one hadith. Watch for your mouth, watch for your tongue, watch for your private parts. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam telling you, you go to Jannah. Let's get to the hadith. Let's get to the verse. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, وَقُلْ لِعِبَادِي يَقُولُ الَّتِي هِيَ أَحْسَنُ إِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ يَنْزَغُ بَيْنَهُمْ إِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ كَانَ لِلْإِنسَانِ عَدُوًّا مُبِينًا. This is the verse. This is it. Can we work on it? Can we think about it? Can we reflect on it? Especially when we go in the mosque. Especially when we talk to Muslims. Especially when we talk to non-Muslims. Anytime we talk. Allah is saying what the meaning is. And say to my slaves that they should only say those words that are the best. Because Shaitan verily sows a state of conflict and disagreements among them. Surely Shaitan is to man a plain enemy. There is something called Hasan and there is Ahsan. Allah is not telling us speak good. You have good, you have better, you have best. You know this in English. I'm not that good, great in English. But you know it in Arabic as well as in English, okay? There is a good. Islam is not telling you speak good. He say what is the best. Go to a higher degree. Don't deal with people in the same mentality. Be you, because who are you? You are قُلْ عِبَادِي. You are one of Allah's slaves. So since you attaching to Allah and Allah choose you and label you with this great label, Allah say, you are my abd. You are my slave. Same way that Allah said to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who can be greater than the Prophet? Allah says, Alhamdulillah, الذي أنزل على عبده الكتاب. All praise be to Allah who had sent and revealed to his slave. So when Allah calling you, you are my slave, this is a great title. This is a lot of privilege for you. You have to know what this mean position. But Allah saying, oh Muhammad, tell my special slaves, the people that I accepted them to be my slaves, my servant, the one who listened to me, obey me, and they follow my direction, what to tell them? To say what is only the best. As example, if somebody said to you, Assalamu alaikum, you can tell him, Wa alaikum assalam, and this is it. But what can be better? He can say, Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullah. He can even know more than this. He can say, Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullah wa barakatuh. You see? Do not. Somebody give you a dollar, he give him a dollar. Somebody say good morning, he say good morning. Somebody give a smile, he give us, and they say, no, we want to take you because you are a Muslim, because you are Abdullah, we want to take you to a higher rank and higher degree, that you be the best in everything, especially in your talk. And why the talk? Because when we talk, this is the moment that your tongue is going like this, fast, quick. And this is the time for your enemy to jump. The shaitan. The shaitan, he was working in your father Adam, doing his best to get him out of what? Out of Jannah. So when we talk, can you imagine if we're angry? No, forget about being angry or upset. Can you imagine even we talk in regular talk? The shaitan is there to try to find some kind of misunderstanding or make you. I wonder, what did he mean by this? What did she mean by this? Why is he? Even when we talk in regular, the shaitan is still. Can you imagine if you're angry? Huh? Now you may say something, you are not paying attention to it. I said, now I know. I told you. I know you. He said, what you know? And now you start to raise your voice, other person raise their voice, and now you're and start. The whole emotion and the whole confusion and the whole things start about the way how we address each other, talk to each other. But what? Because our ego, some of us, their ego is so strong. And I want to prove you that I'm not that easy. You're not going to show me. I show things like you. I'm going to let you know I'm from Harlem, okay? I'm not, you know, I'm down from, yeah, I'm not like these guys, okay? No, you're going to know who I am. You see? The shaitan was waiting for it. Especially when we come together. Especially when brothers, when sisters, now those Muslims, they're communicating, they're talking, they're socializing, they're with each other. Now we have to do something about it. We have to do something about it. We have to confuse them. We have to bring about misunderstanding among them. This is an instruction from Allah, the one who created you and created the shaitan, and he knows about his tricks. He said, watch when you talk to each other. And you always try to say the best. Why? He says, because إِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ يَنْزَغُ بَيْنَهُمْ. He tried to find a space between two words or after once some place, and he will jump in and will bring about disagreement, confusion, argument, fighting, raising voice, and you know what? The next thing, I'm not talking to me, I'm not talking to you, and say yes. The Prophet said 3 days. 3 days for what? We're still Muslims, we're in the same mosque, we're in the same place, we're still husband and wife. What? No, the Prophet said, okay, I have 3 days, I'm going to exercise 3 days. But you, brother, you're the one that start. I don't care who start. But my wife, you're the one who start. I don't care who start. And we try to blame. And we start to understand, instead of fixing it, add more water to the mat. يقول التي هي أحسن. إن الشيطان ينزغ بينهم. And Allah is telling you that the shaitan is a clear, open enemy for you. So my brothers and sisters, we learn today, we're going to watch. Don't let your mouth always open before you use your brain, use your mind. Slow down. Slow down. We are not in competition to win. Who's the faster in talk? Who's the one can say 10 words in a second? Let's slow down. Let's understand, like some people will say, why did Allah create 2 ears for you, only 1 tongue? They say the wisdom behind it, Allah knows best, but this is word of wisdom. Say, so you can listen more than talking. More than talking. Listen. Listen. And what's going to happen if your brother or your sister said a bad word to you, and you took it from here and let it go from the other ear? Let it go. So what? What's the big thing? No, he has to know who is talking to you. No, he has to know who I am. No, he has to know, you understand, who's my father, who's my son, who's my children. I can do... We Abdullah, Ibadullah. You forgot وَكُلِّ عِبَادِي. So the relationship between being Abdullah and the way you talk, you have to show it. Show your ubudiyah in your tongue. And let your tongue submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah give us this guidance and give us the ability that we put this verse in action, inshallah, wherever we go, to whom we talk. الحمد لله رب العالمين وأصلي وأسلم على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين. And the hadith for today, the concise with the verse, listen to this. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم is saying the hadith, which is the meaning is, المؤمن الذي يخالط الناس ويصبر على أذاهم خير من الذي لا يخالط الناس ولا يصبر على أذاهم. But I'm not going to this mosque anymore. This imam is terrible. These people, they really understand, like, I don't know from where they come. Yeah, brothers, they say salam alaikum to each other, but they are not saying salam alaikum to me. These people, you understand, they're so prejudiced. These people, hold it. You want to go and talk with people? You want to be in the mosque? You want to work in a community as one body? Listen what the Prophet, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he made the tashkhis already. Long time ago, he says, the believers who mix with the others, he mix, he doesn't stay home. He doesn't make only the prayer at home because it's too much in the mosque. I could not go to the mosque. Okay. He said, the believers who mix with the people and his patient with their trouble and annoyment. So we understand from this that when we get together, this reflection, like you take two stones, two rocks, two pieces of metal, keep them a distance from each other, nothing. But the moment you come and you start rubbing them like this, heat is coming out. Because this is reality. Now we can stay, everybody can, in his jacuzzi or in his, you understand, whatever it is, swimming pool and enjoy life, watching TV, devil box and everything is fine. Okay? Because nobody that you're talking to, you and the TV, you and the devil. This is it. But the moment that I said, man, why are you under, your voice was so loud in the khutbah. Say, brother, you don't like the khutbah? Okay, there is the other three messages. Yes, this is true. But Imam, can you say it in a better way? Inshallah, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he used to give the khutbah, he used to raise his voice, his face turned red, and he understood, as if he giving warning to our army. Oh, now I understand. So there is a possibility Imam can say one of the two. But the right way for the Imam to say it, what? See, my brother, you see, actually, it's like you call it tough love. Tough love. And I'm talking from my heart. I want to deliver a message to you. But inshallah, I try. But by the way, the sunnah, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he used to talk in the khutbah, he had sometimes the sahaba, they feel the member is shaking, they be scared. Say, oh, the Prophet, maybe the member and the Prophet going to fall. It happens sometimes, okay? So there is two ways to approach. To say the same word, you can give it, but always try to be selective. Not only when you go to food line. You take these tomatoes and you feel it hard. Oh, no, this is the kind one that I needed for salad. And the other one you put it. You make selection, you go to Walmart, everything makes selection. But when we talk to each other, we are not making selection. Why? I don't care. Hey, he don't like, I don't want. He's not my boss, he's not my imam, he's not my manager, you understand? I can go to other mosque. Because we don't have this patience with one another. We need to learn it. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, this believer who do so is much better. All of us always looking for what is better. He said he is much better than the one who doesn't mix with others and he is not patient with their disturbance and their annoyance. So anytime you're going to come in a community, in a committee, in whatever, it's going to be some affliction and some misunderstanding, and it's going to be loud words sometimes, and things like this. But this part of getting together, and this shouldn't make us run away from each other. We have to learn, because it has to be sabr. And subhanAllah, just yesterday, I don't want to get to the subject, but sometimes I understand I could not help it. My mind, all these waves and ideas come to my mind. It's so amazing. Before election, you can see everybody try to bring the dirty laundry of the other one. But as soon you understand this person is the winner, he's the president, everybody sending congratulations and everybody saying this and visiting and go here, everything. SubhanAllah, how the kuffar can accommodate this and we could not accommodate each other? No, yesterday he says this to me. No, she says this, you understand where? Oh, this, you understand. And even some of us, what? Go say, what? She told me such and such. She was talking to you. She was not talking to the whole Muslim community. And you acted like one, so she told you. And sometimes we use words between us and our own wives. But if somebody else outside said it to us, oh, wow. We're going to make a big war in the community about you. Your wife said it to you, you said it to your wife, but when somebody said it to you outside, because the way you act with them, guess sister what? This sister, this brother, they said such and such. Look to the non-Muslims, and they bring effects, and they give you understand, show you every dirty thing in your laundry, bring it outside to make you lose the election. But after this, everything is fine. We Muslims, this is the teaching of our deen. This is the forgiveness. To be kind, to be gentle, to forget about it, keep going. We have something more important than sit down, you understand, boycotting one another and angry at each other and make the whole community, understand, falling down because somebody calls the other person, you understand, a nickname or a defamed name or whatever it is. Now, the Prophet told us, وَيَصْبِرُ عَلَىٰ أَذَاهُمْ, and he's patient with their annoyance. Whenever we're going to come together, we have to exercise our patience. That means when you run away that you have a problem. You have deficiency. You don't have enough sabr to deal with your Muslim brothers and sisters. And this is against Islam. Because Islam always talking about sabr, patience. With this, inshallah, hopefully, that for myself as well as you, that we're going to reflect on this verse and this hadith, and I try to put it in action, inshallah. I want to pass some announcement, or actually one announcement. Tuesday class by Brother Adli is going to be shifted to Wednesday, inshallah. So this way that we give the people break and we don't lose the students, okay? So we'll continue with Monday class with Brother Ansari, and after this you have a break, and after this you come to Wednesday, if you want to come, and this will be, you understand, and after this Thursday will be a break, and after this you come to Jum'ah. So we give the people, you understand, because we know you have other things to do. So inshallah, check website almasjid.com to see what's going on. And please remember that CIC coming next week. So hopefully, inshallah, that you already had made room in your schedule to welcome the people who are coming out of town, because this mini conference is going to be here in the mosque, inshallah. Again, please kindly focus in this hadith and focus in this verse, and try to put it in action. We need it. We need to live it. We need to show others the best of ourselves, not the worst of us. I beg Allah's forgiveness for me and you and all the Muslims. Ameen. Wa akhir da'wana anil hamdulillahi rabbil alameen.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar.